Assalamualaikum and good day to everyone. Here is chapter 10, Quantum Physics. Hertz discovered the light incident on certain metallic surfaces caused the emission of electrons from the surfaces. This phenomenon is known as the photoelectric effect, and the emitted electrons are called photoelectrons. The figure here is a schematic diagram of a photoelectric effect apparatus. An evacuated glass tube known as a photocell contains a metal plate E, the emitter, connected to the negative terminal of a variable power supply. Another metal plate C, which is the collector, is maintained at a positive potential by the power supply. When the tube is kept in the dark, the emitter reads zero, indicating that there is no current in the circuit. When plate E is illuminated by light having a wavelength shorter than some particular wavelength that depends on the material used to make plate E, a current is detected by the emitter, which indicates a flow of charges across the gap between E and C. This current arises the photoelectrons emitted from the negative plate E and collected at the positive plate C. This plot is of the photoelectric current versus the potential difference between E and C for the two light intensities. At large value of delta V, the current reaches a maximum value. Also notice that the current increases as the incident light intensity increases. Finally, when delta V is negative, that is when the power supply in the circuit is reversed to make E positive and C negative, the current drops to a low value because most of the emitted photoelectrons are repelled by the now negative plate C. In this situation, only those electrons having a kinetic energy greater than the magnitude of E delta V reach C, where E is the charge on the electron. When delta V is equal to or more negative than stopping potential, no electrons reach C and the current is zero. The stopping potential is independent of the radiation intensity. The maximum kinetic energy of the photoelectrons is related to the stopping potential through this relationship. Ke max equals to E delta V S. From the conservation of energy, the decrease in oscillator energy HF must be equal to the photon's energy E, and the result is given here, where phi is called the work function of the metal. The work function represents the minimum energy with which an electron is bound in the metal and is on the order of a few electron volts. Table 27.1 shown work functions for various metals. Experimentally, a linear relationship is observed between F and Ke max. The intercept of the horizontal axis corresponding to Ke max equals to 0 gives the cutoff frequency below which no photoelectrons are emitted, regardless of light intensity. We can derive the cutoff wavelength lambda c equals to hc over phi, where c is the speed of light. No photoelectrons are emitted for wavelengths greater than lambda c, incident on a material with work function phi. Here is the relationship between momentum and energy for a photon. We can express the momentum of photon here and the energy of photon here. De Broglie suggested all material particles with momentum p should have a characteristic wavelength lambda equals to h over p, because the momentum of a particle of mass m and speed v is mv. The de Broglie wavelength of a particle is given by this relationship. The de Broglie wavelength is given by this relationship. De Broglie postulated that the frequencies of matter waves or waves associated with particles having non-zero rest energy. The dual nature of matter is apparent in these last two equations because each contains both particles concepts m, v and e and wave concept lambda and f. The fact that these relationships had been established experimentally for photons made the de Broglie hypothesis that much easier to accept. That's all for chapter 10. Thank you.